Time to go live. Hello, everybody. Thank you very much for joining me on this. Feels like a Friday. What is it? Tuesday. Tuesday afternoon. Welcome to a solo playthrough of one of the hottest games of this year and a lot of people's number one game of this year, Ark Nova. As always with these live playthroughs, please let me know in the chat if you can hear me and you can see me okay. And today is just going to be mainly a solo playthrough. I'm not going to be doing a tutorial today. I have already done a tutorial video, which is on the channel. I've put a link to that in the chat, if you're interested. I will go over how the solo game works, though, for those people who are interested. But the objective of this game is that we are trying to get as many points as we can get by moving our appeal marker counterclockwise around the track and our conservation marker clockwise around the track. Now, in the multiplayer game, you keep playing until somebody's markers have crossed. In the solo game, we basically play for 6 rounds. So in the solo game, we have this little card here, and we populate it with cubes of another player. And every single time I take a turn, we move that across there. So there isn't an AI, there isn't an automa doing anything else. It is literally me just taking turns one after the other. But then after I have taken 7 turns, as soon as that goes there, that marks the end of what in the rule book is called the first round. And what happens is we then have a break. So a break triggers at certain points in the game, multiplayer game. In the solo game, after 7 turns, we trigger the first break. We don't take that cube off. We take that cube off. That cube comes off, and then these are all going to go back there. Then we're going to start round two. So you can see in round two, I've only got 6 turns. So essentially, I play the game over 6 rounds in ever-decreasing number of turns per round. And then certain things happen in the break, and then at the end we basically score up. So unlike the multiplayer game, where it is down to the actions of the players that determine the end of the game, this one has a fixed length. We're going to be playing over 6 rounds, but as I say, it's 7 turns. So how many turns is that? 7 turns. 7 turns, then 6, so that's 13. Then 5, so that's 18. Then 4, so that's 22. Then 3, so that's 25. Then 2, 20, so 27. So I'm going to get 27 turns in the game, and that's it. Right. I have done the setup. The 4 break tiles have been chosen. Not break tiles, the 4 bonus tiles have been chosen. They are there, which is, let me just refresh my memory on what these are. It's not on here. No, it is on here. That is. I'm guessing it's get a card, a player sponsor card, and pay for it. Oh, it's on here somewhere. Here we go. Player sponsor card from your hand by paying X money, where X is the level of the card, right? That's that. That is get a free 3-space enclosure. That is gain one of the universities, and that is get 10 money. Now, for my player board, yeah, positive score. If you get 0, then you win. And I'm playing on the easy setting, which means I actually start with 20 appeal. You can customize the difficulty setting based on where you want to start. But the reason I'm starting on 20 appeal is I am using map 0. So when you first play the game, it recommends you use map A, which basically gives you a free enclosure and a free kiosk. I'm going to be using map 0 today. And then there are 8 asymmetric maps if you want to play with those. The other thing is I have chosen the 3 starting conservation projects, and we have these are basically objectives: predators in your zoo, herbivores in your zoo, and Asia icons in your zoo. Right, now I also have 2 endgame scoring cards which have been dealt randomly. One of them, and this is interesting, this, and I'm curious to see for those people who are watching this who've played before, I have a final endgame scoring card which gives me bonus conservation points for empty building spaces in your zoo. So one of the things you're trying to do is to build up in your complete zoo. Because if you do, if you fill your zoo, you're going to get 7 appeal by the end of the game. But this card goes against that. This card means that I'm going to get awarded at the end of the game for the number of empty building spaces that I have. I'm curious to see if anybody can turn this into a strategy and actually not build. Because I've counted, there's a lot more than 24. But that's one of them. The other option is to have sponsor cards in my zoo. So the more sponsor cards I have, the more end game scoring. And at the end of the game, I'm only going to score one of these. Now, At the start of the game, you get 8 cards from the deck of cards. And now the deck of cards is huge. There's like, how many? A couple of hundred? Some crazy amount of cards. 212 zoo cards. Right, so 212 zoo cards. And what happens is each player will get 8 of them at the start of the game. And now out of these 8, you choose 4 to start with. Now, from my limited knowledge of the game, what you're doing is you're looking for combos with things that already exist in the game. So for example, we've got objective cards or conservation cards for predators, herbivores, and Asia. And I have endgame scoring cards for sponsor cards. Right, and I've drawn no sponsor cards, literally none. I've drawn no Asia icons. I've drawn no predators. And I've drawn one herbivore. So literally my 8 starting cards, apart from one herbivore, don't match anything else. Daniel is saying go for small animals with small enclosures. Yeah. Yeah, small animals, small enclosures. Isn't that card for empty buildings, not empty spaces? No, it's empty spaces. Well, it's empty building spaces. In other words, not the mountains and not the water. So I'm not sure of these cards, which ones to take. While I'm thinking, though, just wanted to mention for those people who are watching either live or watching back afterwards, this is not a sponsored video. These videos are only made possible through the support of the Patreon campaign. And as you can see at the bottom, we're currently on a countdown to 800. It says 19 to go. That's actually not true because between me making that graphic this morning and now, somebody has left the Patreon. So it's actually 20. But if you like the content they create, obviously give the video a thumbs up. But if you are in a position to be able to support me on Patreon and help fund the channel, patreon.com/gamingreal. So a big thank you to all of my Patreon supporters for helping keep the channel alive. And as I say, the link is there if you want to support me directly. So what are we gonna take? If we are going to go with this one, we want lots of small enclosures. And we're actually not going to fill the board very much at all. But we want to cover these bonus spaces because they're bonuses. So we could try and go for this one because the sponsor cards, I've not got any sponsor cards. So let's have a look. Small animals. If we're going to go with small animals, we have a slow worm. We get a lot of them in the garden. We also have this conservation card, the Blue Mountains National Park. It is a... Should there be a space there? Is that a typo? I thought National Park was two words. that's to release animals with Australia icons. Well, I do have the Laughing Kookaburra for each Australia icon in all zoos. That's not very good in solo. So that's probably going to go. A common wall lizard. We could have that. These are both really small animals. The Scarlet Macaw. Get a free kiosk or pavilion. That's pretty good. But to play it, I need... that's a zoo, isn't it? Yeah, I need a partner zoo. And what was the rule that I got wrong last time I played? I think I got the rule wrong that partner zoo... Yeah, has to be the same continent of the animal. So to play the Scarlet Macaw, I need to have a partner zoo in the Americas. Yeah. Which I could do. Which means I probably want to pick another Americas card. So we could play that one. And if we're going to go for a partner zoo in the Americas, do I also want to play the Mountain Tapir? Which is a herbivore, which is the only card towards that. So it could be these 5 cards. I mean, that requires 2 science icons. That's quite hard to play. Maybe we'll get rid of that one and we'll keep that one. Okay, so they are my 4 starting cards that I have chosen. And in terms of the... I just want to mention this briefly. There's still a lot of people comparing this to Terraforming Mars. And I think that's not right. I think the only comparison to Terraforming Mars is this game has lots and lots of cards, 200 cards, that are all unique, that have icons on them, with a cost to play, and things that work like tags. That's it. There is nothing else in the game at all which is like Terraforming Mars. So for those people out there that are still saying, oh, it's a bit like Terraforming Mars, it's not like Terraforming Mars at all. I just want to get that out there. In my opinion, not like Terraforming Mars at all, except for the way the cards work. And even then, you don't even draft them or anything. So, yeah, it's very different. Okay, now that we've done that, we now reveal these six cards. This is the display. Now, I can't really take from the display yet, unless I... What's that ability called? Snap. But as my reputation increases, I think that's my reputation, and if I've improved these cards, then I can. Somebody's comparing it to Wingspan. There's birds in it. Other than that, there is zero comparison to Wingspan. Wow. And I'm saying that not having actually played Wingspan, but that's crazy. Unless it is. If you think it's comparable to Wingspan, let me know. Right, okay. So what are we doing? I'm going to choose an action. Now, the rules say that you choose an action, slide the card down, do the action, and then move it along. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to just mark it with a cube. I find that a bit easier to do. Right, let's have a look. What do we want to do at the start of the game? Well, that's interesting. My association card is in the 5 space. But that's going to allow me to do any one of these. Now, that's really good if you want to do this or this. But actually, I probably want a partner zoo in the Americas in order to be able to play these cards. Depends what we're going to play first. I do probably want to introduce... And then the building will be there. Yeah, I mean, I've got the money. I have the money. I think I'm going to perform... I'm going to do the association action first. And I'm not going to use it... I can do it at the maximum value of 5, but I've not got 5. So we're going to do that, and we're going to perform the association action using this assistant. Is it an assistant? Oh, I'm tempted to go with this one, because I can. But no, I'm going to go with this one, and I'm going to get a partner zoo in the Americas, and that's going to go there, and that's going to give me a 3 discount for every America icon on every card that I buy. And that is it. That card goes to the end, or the start. Okay, and then that cube moves across. That is my first turn done. Nice and easy. Right, second turn. I probably want to build. And the build card is in the 5 position. So I think that's what we're going to do. We're going to build. Oh no, it's only build 1 building. Oh. I wanted to build lots of little buildings. And if I am going to go with this Naturalist's Zoo card, we want to build lots of small enclosures. So that's not going to work, is it? I can't play a sponsorship card because I haven't got any sponsor cards. We could take the cards action. We could take this. With strength 3, it would be draw 2 and discard 1. And I can't snap. So it would literally be just drawing 2 cards from that massive stack of cards and seeing what we get. So no, I think we're just going to go with the build. Even though I can build with a maximum size of 5, I'm going to build a size 2 pavilion. So a size 2 pavilion, which is going to cost 4 money. Let's get some change. Because I'm going to put my mountain to pier in it. Now, my mountain to pier wants to be next to mountains. So, now the first one that you place, if I've got this right, the first one has to go on the edge. Is that right? Because I've only ever played with the basic map where you already start off with something. Pay the building cost, enclosures. Build the building adjacent to an existing one. For your first building, at least 1 space of it must be on a border space of your zoo map. Right, so I can actually start anywhere. Well, that's interesting, because this card is here, which is going to give me income based on the number of bird icons I have in the zoo. Do I want to take that? I could actually go here and take that card into my hand, and then I could play it with this. That would generate me money. It would get me an appeal for having a bird once I've got the bird. Yeah. Okay. Oh, small animals. We've got a project, a conservation thing here for small animals. That's going to be really, really helpful. Okay. Let's go with here. So I'm building my size 2 enclosure here. I've covered over that icon, which means I get 2 reputation. So I've got up to 3 reputation. Nice. Okay. That is it. That is my one build that I have done. That card now goes to the end. Okay, and another cube goes across. Right. So, let's have a look at where we are now. I could now play the animals, because with 3 I can play 1 animal. So that's a possibility. Or we could break, which would be draw 2 cards and not have to discard any. But remember, but when you get to a break, you have to discard down to a hand size of 3. That's... Oh, actually, I forgot that that's got a secondary ability of gain 5 money, because I can't play a sponsorship card. So it's either animals, I can do animals, but I'm tempted to do 2 animals at once. So I am going to choose the sponsors card, and I'm going to use the secondary ability. Now, in the solo game, you ignore the break abilities, so I'm basically going to gain 5 money. And that's it. That is my turn done. 27 turns is not going to be anywhere near enough. I've had 3. Right. I think I want to build again. Because then I can play 2 animals. Oh, I can only play 2 animals if the card goes down to the bottom. Ah. Yeah. No, that's fine. That's fine. So, we've got that. We've got that, yep. So the next one is going to have to be adjacent to this building. So I'm going to do it. I'm going to build. I'm going to spend 2 money. Oh, I'm loving this already. I can tell you now, spoilers, this is one of my top games of the year. I won't be doing my top 10 games of 2021 until next year, but this is in there. I can tell you right now. It's really good. So we're building a size 1 enclosure, which has to be... Well, or I can build a kiosk, or I can build the pavilion. But no, we're going to build a size 1 enclosure. This is going to be for my bird or slow worm. I don't know which. So I'm going to go here. There you go. There's my size 1 enclosure. And that's it. That is my 4th turn done. Right, turn number 5. I'm choosing the cards action. So if I wanted to, I could draw 3 and discard 1, or I could snap by taking any of them, irrespective of where my reputation marker is. Now that's where all the conservation cards are. That water playground's quite nice. But, see, drawing 3 and discarding 1, bearing in mind I'm then going to lose... Yeah, I'm going to lose the cards, aren't I? So I am tempted... to... Just having a look at the meerkat den. If you've got 6 herbivores at the end of the game, get a point. Gorilla Field Research is only... I need 3 science icons to play it. That's not going to happen. Meerkat Den is actually quite good. But I don't think I'm going to get to play it because I've already moved my sponsors card to the end. And I'm about to play the herbivore. So... I'm not sure whether I want to draw 3 and discard 1. Yeah, I'm going to do that. I'm going to do the draw 3, discard 1. So draw 3 from the deck. We have an expert on Africa. Every time I play an Africa icon in my zoo, I can place an action card on one, right? Or the African ostrich, or the Andean condor. None of these are really good for me. I mean, that is a bird, and if I'm going to take that, but that's also America's. Yeah, we're going to keep... So it's draw three and discard one. Now, the one I discard could be from hand. And these are both birds. But I like my little lizard. So I'm going to draw... I'm going to get rid of the expert on Africa. We don't want that one. Okay. That is my go done. That moves to the end. Time is running out. We've got two more turns before the first break. And then stuff happens. So we're going to be animals-ing. And we're going to be playing two animals. So I'm going to be playing the mountain tapir, which requires a size 2 enclosure next to mountains and is going to cost me 15. And then I'm going to be playing... Oh no, I get a 3 discount. Yeah, 3 discount because of the university. Okay, so I can also play, I believe, I mean, that's going to have an ability when it comes in. No, I can't quite play that. So it might have to be Sammy the Slowworm. Yeah, so Sammy the Slowworm needs a size 1 enclosure next to water, and it's going to cost me 4. Yeah, okay. Right, so that enclosure is now occupied. That enclosure is occupied. My zoo has started and is open. So let's have a look at the mountain tapir. I gain 1 conservation point. I gain 4 appeal. I get 2 appeal for the slow worm. And then this has an ability. Digging 2. Choose up to 2. Discard 1 card from the display and replenish. Or discard 1 card from your hand to draw 1 card from the deck. Okay. Right. I mean, that's quite nice. But these two cards are going to disappear anyway. Oh, I need that one. Oh, no, I think I might have messed this up. I want that card. How am I going to get that card? I don't think I am. Oh, rats. So twice, I can cycle cards around. Well, I'm not bothered about. Oh, I'm gonna have to lose some cards anyway. I'm gonna have to discard down to 3. So I'm gonna get rid of that card and draw a replacement. It's a size 2 herbivore. Nice. And then I'm gonna discard that card. No. Because I've got 3 in hand. So I'm going to discard the meerkat den. No, I'm going to discard the gorilla field research. And replace it with that. Which is a greater rear. Is that right? Not Chris rear. Greater rear. Digging 2. Choose, discard a card from the display and replenish. Now when it says replenish, it might be you slide everything down. I'm just going to look that up. If anybody knows. Can you build on a snap space as a last action? I don't think I can take that one. I don't think so. Digging. If you choose to discard a card from the display, replenish it immediately according to the usual rules. So the usual rules are everything slides down and then a new one comes in. Right. So that's that done. And that's that done. And then you can stack these cards up. I now have 2 animals in my zoo. Come visit me. Right. Cube goes across. Card goes along. My last turn of the first round before the break. What are we going to do? I want to take this, but I can't. I can only play a card from there when I have upgraded my association action to level 2. Which only happens when I've done a card upgrade. Oh, which is soon. I'm almost there. So I can't really do the association because my assistant is over there. Can't really do sponsors. Well, I could to get full money. I could build another building. I think we might have to build another building. Yeah, so we've got the Himalayan tapir, which requires size 2. So yeah, we're going to build. We're going to build a size 2 enclosure. This is a weird game. Not done anything like. Ah, I can. I can do it. Mwah! If that's what you're meaning. Keeping the channel free of political and social justice issues. Yeah, I don't really go in for that. But yes, thank you very much to the people who were shouting at me that I can do this because I can now do it. So I'm building two. Sorry, I'm building one building of size 2. I've paid for it. It's going there, and I'm covering over that icon, which means I can take a card within my reputation range, which is this one. Right. It does mean I am going to have to discard a card, though, because I've now got four cards in hand. But I got the card I wanted to. Right. We are done. That is it. End of the first round. So we do the break. So, discard down to three cards. So I'm definitely keeping that one. I'm definitely keeping that one because it's a herbivore. We're getting rid of the Andean condor because he's quite ugly, to be honest. I think we're going to get rid of this. I could keep the Scarlet Macaw now. Oh, I've got to keep the Scarlet Macaw because the ability is amazing. Three free kiosks and pavilions. Yeah, we're keeping that. Sorry, Mr. Common Wall Lizard, but you are gone. Right. What's next? That top cube goes on the top space there. And then that's it. So that's the end of the first round. And that's 7 turns in out of 27. Okay, off we go then. 20 turns left. Oh, and I get my thing back. Where's that on here? It's not on here. Surely you get them back though. Yeah, and you get income based on that, which I've not got any of that. Right, okay, so let's have a look where we are. Animals, I've got the animal there. I'll be playing that later on. I'm not playing that anytime soon because I need lots of small animals for that. Oh, I get income. Yeah, I get 19 income. Best not forget that. Oh, and discard the left two Mercos, thank you. I knew there was other things that I'd forgotten. I was thinking break time normally takes longer than that. Broad-snouted caiman. Right. Okay, have we done everything? I think we've done everything. Done that. Done that. And normally you would replenish these, but in a solo game there's no point because you can only have one of each anyway. Right. Okay, so. What are we gonna do? What are we gonna do? That's probably staying where it is. That's probably staying where it is. I could introduce an animal. It could be the Malayan tapir. That would give me my second herbivore, which is enough to claim that. Oh, it is, isn't it? I'm not going to association yet. I'm not going to sponsors. It's either animals. I could animals and play the tapir. Or do we play the Scarlet Macaw and start building the free stuff? I might want to build before I do that. And then I could do animals and do both of them, but I need the money. How do you get the money? Money's quite hard to get by in this game. Yeah, the break steps on the right-hand side of the solo card. But yeah, they're not everything. That's the thing. It's the start, but there's dotted lines that basically mean you do the rest of these. So it's easier just to use these, I think. Oh, I'm debating what to do. Because if I get another university, that unlocks one of my cards to become a level 2 card. Yeah, I really don't know. I could build, but then I'd want the animals to get up to here to play two of them. But I've only got 23 money. So, yeah, how am I going to get... Oh, playing attractive animals to boost your income. What? So you're saying that this mountain to peer is not attractive? I mean, you know, maybe a bit of lipstick. But I know what you mean. You move this up, and the more this is, more this goes up, the more your income goes up, and your kiosks will give you money as well. But I haven't got any kiosks, which is why I'm thinking this is actually going to be quite useful. Ah, and if I build on that space, I get to take one of these two cards, and I could go for the water playground. And the water playground could go here. Let's do that. Right. What are we doing? Building. We're going to build. It's only in one, so it's going to be a size one enclosure. And it's going to be built there. So that's going to cost me two money. And I'm going to take a card from within my reputation range. And it's going to be the water playground. Okay, so that goes into my hand. That's the build action done. That card goes to the end. First cube slides across. There we go. Next, I'm going to choose the animals card. No. Doesn't really matter. I'm going to choose the sponsors card, and I am going to play water playground. So I need the special tile for the water playground, which is in here somewhere. There it is. Water playground, and it has to be next to at least one water space. So I'll put it there, which gets me 10 money. Nice. Okay, and my appeal goes up by 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Done, done, done. That card goes across. That cube goes across there. I think I've had the water playground in most games that I've played. Hand size up to 5. Yeah. Yeah, but that means buying a university. There's just not enough time to do everything that I want to do. So now we do have enough money to play both of these. I do have enough money to play both the Scarlet Macaw and the Menelaian Tapir. If I can get that animals card to the end. I don't think we're going to do an association of anything else, are we? So it might have to be the university. Ooh. Yeah, that is tricky. Yeah, I'm not going to do a conservation card at this point. So we're going to association with a strength of 5. Do we go for the university with the hand size? I mean, I don't need the science icons. The other option is that we go for another partner zoo. And if we go for another partner zoo, that means we can upgrade one of our cards. And that means that I can then play two animals on the next turn. So we're going to do that. I'm going to go here. We're going to have a partner zoo in Asia. And because I'm covering over that icon, I'm going to flip over my animals card. Done. Done. That goes down. That goes across. This is a great solo mode. Really nice. As long as you don't want another player that you're playing against, this solo mode is fine. I do have two. I will have two herbivores in a minute, so I could do that. But I kind of, if I can wait till it's a bit better. I've also got two small animals in my zoo, so I could do this if I wanted to. But I'm going to wait because it's better if I wait a bit more. Right, we're now doing the animals card, so I can now play two animals. Oh, actually, if I wait till I've got that even better, I get a reputation. I could do that then. Let's do that. Let's do the cards action. And I'm just going to draw two cards from the deck. So, what have we got? We've got a guinea pig. Oh, he's so cute. He's a petting zoo animal. So, I need a petting zoo to put him in. And a northern giraffe. A northern giraffe. He goes down to shops. Right. Now, it's a big animal, but it is a herbivore. So, that might be quite useful. Okay, so that's the cards action done. Cube goes across. That goes down there. Right. Now I'm going to do the animals action. So I get one reputation and I can play two animals. And I'm going to play the Malayan tapir at a discount of three. So that costs 14. And the scarlet macaw at a discount of three for 13. So that's 27 money. That's a lot of money, but I believe Paul's Tapir Zoo. So that's going to go in there. And that's going to go in there. So let's do the Scarlet Macaw first, because the Scarlet Macaw has got four appeal. And I can up to three times place a free kiosk or pavilion. Now, kiosks are the ones that's going to give me money. Pavilions are the ones that are going to give me an immediate appeal. So I'm just going to do the appeal from the tapir first. And a reputation. Oh, which is another card. So I'm owed a card flip. So I think I'm going to take one pavilion and two kiosks. So that. Other way around. So that one pavilion gets me one appeal. Now, kiosks have to be at least three away from each other, and they are going to get points, or they're going to get money for everything that they're next to. Is that right? I think that's right. So I'm going to put one in there, which is awesome. Actually, that's the best place for one. Because that is one, two, three, four. Yeah, that is it's next to four things. But this could only go like here. But that's okay. And then the pavilion can go wherever you want, really. Now do kiosks score for pavilions? If they do, then that's even better. Yeah, only flipped tiles. Yeah, it's only enclosures that are nearby. Which thematically makes sense. So that's the Scarlet Macaw done. Now we've got the Malayan Tapir. So I get the reputation. So I'm owed another card flip. Which card do I want to upgrade now? It's probably going to be the build card because that's going to allow me to then split my build across multiple different buildings. And I get the Digging 3 ability. So I'm keeping that. I'm keeping that. What are we going to do with this Northern Giraffe? It's expensive. It requires a size 3 enclosure. I'm tempted to keep the petting zoo because it's a size 1 animal, which is going to be useful for the small animals. I'm not sure. I'm not sure. What have we got here? So the releasing things into the wild doesn't really fit with my small animal strategy, although. You still get three conservation points for releasing a lizard into the wild. So Simon the Slow Worm might get released into a sea cave. And that's quite good as well. That's really good. end of the game for the different continents. I've got three continents already. Oh, you need all five. Oh, no, it's one for each five. Right, okay. It's not very... I was thinking it was one for each. That's really good with that. But I don't want to have to build a size 4 enclosure. I don't know what to do with this digging ability. Dumb Gerald is what the chat is saying. But he's a herbivore. And if I can get to 4 herbivores, or even 5, that's really good. What? Oh, you mean the guinea pig? Is Gerald the guinea pig? Yeah, see, that's... Petting zoo animals are good, but you need more of them. And we're gonna get rid of the he's too big. No, he's fine, he's a herbivore. I'm so tempted to keep it. I'm keeping the giraffe. I'm gonna dump the guinea pig and draw a replacement. It's a reindeer, which is also a herbivore. That's 4 herbivores. Which is really good for that. Ah, but they don't fit with the small animal strategy. Oh. Yeah, okay. That's my first one. Second one. That's a herbivore as well. That's an even bigger one. Second one, third one. Let's just bin those. There you go. An alpine ibex. That's size 2. Well, there we go. That was my introducing animals. That went well. I'm ready for another break because I've not got much money. We have one turn left. And I could do another build. Is there anything else I want to do? I don't want to do a sponsor card. I could do two little builds. Which might be the right thing to do. It's either that or take 4 money with the sponsors. So the alpine ibex is a herbivore, it needs a size 2 enclosure, and it needs to be next to 2 mountains, which is there. That will work. We have a perfect space for it. So I'm going to build. And I am just going to build, with my 4 money, a size 2 enclosure there. Now, that's not covering over any icons. So, actually, I don't want to build it there. Let's build it. Let's build it there. If I build it over here, it's still next to 2 mountains, and I get one of those X markers or plus markers, whatever you want to call them. Let's do that. Okay. Are the 5 actions always the same? Yes, they are. Always the same 5 actions, but you can upgrade them during the game. And yeah, I haven't unlocked a second worker. I only have 1 worker. Okay, so that's my build action done. I built the size 2 enclosure. I got the bonus. That goes across. That goes there. That goes there. And that goes across. And we have a break. So discard down to 3 cards. Got 3 cards. Replenish the universities. Get rid of these 2. Everything slides down. Oh, card with more icons and text than you can possibly imagine. Done that. Income. I am 23 income. It's 23. And kiosks. So this kiosk does. So do kiosks score for pavilions? That's the question. Rule book. Where are the rules on breaks? Break. Kiosks. Check each kiosk. One money for each unique building, special enclosure, occupied standard enclosure, and pavilion. Nice. So this kiosk gets me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this kiosk gets me 1. So I get 6 additional money. Nice. Okay. Right. Next. Yeah, the money's not ideal, to be honest, in terms of component. I mean, the quality of the component is fine. It's just, it's a grey square. The graphic design is clear in this game. It's a little bit simplistic, but it's clear. That's the main thing. Right, I think we're done. That cube now goes onto here, and it is now my turn again, because it's always my turn. So we're ready to introduce, where is it? This. And I can now play that. When I play the animals card, I can play that. Oh, and I get this back. So I can actually do that now if I want to. But I think we are best... Yeah, can't play that because I need to have 2 lizards already. What do we want to do? What do we want to do? I'm tempted to wait for this animal thing to get up to here. But I don't know whether it's going to. I don't think we need a university. How are we doing for herbivores? We've got 2 herbivores and 2 more in hand. We want to build, so I need to wait for my build card to get up here. And in terms of small animals, we have 4 at the moment. And I need at least 1 more, I think, for this to be worthwhile. So I think it might be the animals card. And bring the Alpine Ibex into play. Yeah. That's what I think it is. Don't forget you pay the card slot in money when paying stuff from the display. Ah, yes. That rule that I keep forgetting about. I may have forgotten that earlier on, but thank you very much for that. That is, did I forget that earlier on, or have I not done that yet? Yeah, it is a rule that I keep forgetting about. Whenever you play a card from the display, you have to pay the money on the slot. I think that's what we're going to do anyway. So I'm going to choose the animals action, and I am going to play this animal from here, because I can, because I've upgraded my card. So it's 10 plus 3, no discount. So it's going to cost me 13. But my Alpine Ibex comes into play. It needs a size 2 enclosure that's next to 2 mountains, which I have. So that goes there. It gets me 5 appeal. And advance the break token 2 spaces. You don't do that, but you still get the money. Right, that is my Alpine Ibex. And that was my animals action. So that's gone across, that's gone there, that goes there. Okay. Next. So I've got 5 small animals. We are almost at the point where I'm thinking of doing this. So we probably need to get this sponsors out of the way. Oh, everything needs to slide down. But you don't pay for sponsor cards, do you? Oh, I can't take it from there anyway. Oh, that would be good. Expert in small animals. Bit late for that. So I think we're going to do the sponsors action just to take 5 money. Which moves that down to there and moves that across to there. And now we're going to do the association action with a value of 5 and we're going to do this. So I'm going to play a small animals card from my hand. Now the cube that you put on it comes from here. So this is where I now get to unlock one of these special abilities. And these are all amazing. Which one? Because the bottom ones are just immediate effects. The top ones are immediate and income. And I do like that conservation thing. I don't know. Do people have a preference? Oh yeah, I've got the X token as well. So I could have done association. Yeah. Never mind. I've done it now. But that, thank you. Yeah. I'd forgotten that. Spartan 117. Yeah, could have done that. Never mind. Anyway, which one of these am I going to take? What's that top one? Just have a look at what that top one is. Snap. Take any one card from the display. All right, okay. And then I could release the sea cave, release the reptile into the wild. It's pretty good, that. Although the size 2 enclosure, building a free size 2 enclosure, is it free? I think it's free, yeah. And as income, that's going to be a lot of size 2 enclosures. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know which of these is... I mean, they're all good. I do quite like the income ones, though. Okay, so I'm going to choose this one. I like this one because it's one conservation point now and then one in income. So that's going to go on the 5 because I have 5 small animals. So I get 1 conservation point from that and 3 from that. So I get 1, 2, 3, 4. So I unlock one of those 2 abilities. And I also unlock one of those abilities. Oh boy, right. So, do we need another worker? I'm not sure I do. No. So I am going to upgrade another card. And I am going to upgrade... Which one do we upgrade? I'm going to upgrade the association card. I think. That's the card I'm going to upgrade. So that was that. And then here, I'm going to have a free size 3 enclosure for Gerald. Now, where does Gerald like to live? He's not bothered. As long as it's size 3. It's either Gerald or Rudolph. I've got a reindeer. Oh, and in fact, reindeer is a flock animal. It can share the existing enclosure of a herbivore with size 3. So I can play the northern giraffe first, and then the reindeer can occupy it. Excellent. So where's this going to go? And I have upgraded my build card, so it can go here, which moves things around. Oh, hello. This works. Yeah, so I'm going to build it here, which I can because of that icon, because I'm at build 2, and I've covered over that icon, and that icon means after finishing this action, place any action card on slot 1. Which I'm doing. How am I building? I'm building because of a bonus there. That's that bonus gone and out of the game. Right, and then we finish the association action. Goes to the end, and then I use the clever ability to move this action to there. Okay, and then that goes across. There you go. That was a pretty epic turn. I think I got that right. Right, back to me. Well, animals is here. Have I got 28? I haven't got 28. Do I get any discount? I get a 3 discount. So I need 25. I haven't got 25. I'm too short. Otherwise, I could have played these two. And that would have been awesome. That would have been very awesome. I mean, we could sponsors first. Sponsors and then animal. Just to get the extra bit of money. I'll tell you what, I think it might work. It seems a little bit of a waste, but I quite like it. So we're going to go sponsors to take 3 money. That card goes to there. That moves to there. Then I am going to choose the animals card, boosting it by 1. So it becomes a 5 to give me 1 reputation and allows me to play 2 animals, which are these two, which we've worked out costs 25. So first of all, we play the Northern Giraffe, which requires a size 3 enclosure and gives me 7 appeal. And after finishing the current action, I can move my sponsor card. Right, then I play the reindeer, which can share an existing enclosure of a herbivore of size 3 or more, which gives me 5 appeal. Okay, nice. Right, and I can move the sponsor's card if I want to, but I don't want to. And that's the animals action done. And that goes to the end. And the cube moves across and we have a break. So let's get things right. Let's move that back. Let's get rid of these two cards. Let's get my income of 27. 27. Discard down to 3 cards. I have no cards in hand. So that doesn't actually do anything. I haven't got any other income. Kiosks. So that kiosk gets me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And that one gets me 6, 7. So I get 7 more. 7 more money from my kiosks. I need to remove the action upgrade token. Action upgrade token. This one. Yeah, it's printed on the board. Can't remove it. These are removable, and in fact I can remove that one now because I've gone past it. Again, in a solo game it doesn't really matter because you can't go back. I think we're done. I think I've removed the cards, I've slid everything down. Right. Now I have 5 herbivores. So this is absolutely gonna happen. Oh, income, I get another conservation point. This is absolutely going to happen this time. But first, we're going to build. And I can build multiple buildings of multiple types. So we're going to choose the build action. Total size of 5. Do we just build 5 little buildings? Let's have a look at the animals currently on display. There's nothing there that I want. We've already done the small animals thing. So actually, at this point, I'm not getting any end-of-game scoring for small animals. I'm getting end-of-game scoring for empty spaces in my zoo. I'm not going to bother with the sponsor cards because I've only got 1 of them. So I think, yeah, we're going to build. Right, how many empty spaces have I got in my zoo? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12... 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. So I've currently got 23 spaces in my zoo. So I'm already on this one. If I build 5 more and stay there, then that's 3 conservation points at the end of the game. Oh, 1 of each type. Yeah, you're right. I cheated earlier then, didn't I? Oh, no, that was free, 3 free things. Yeah, this is 1 of each type. It doesn't say that on there. Oh, no, it does say that on there. It says different. Okay, so I could build a size 1, a size 2, a kiosk, and a pavilion. Let's do that. So I spend 8. Love this game. It's brilliant. Size 1, size 2, kiosk and a pavilion. Right, where are we all going? We don't know what we need at all, but I'm going to put the size 2 one down here, which covers up this 2 reputation bonus, moving to there, getting me a worker, or an association worker, whatever they're called. Ooh. It's quite nice as well. That is quite nice, actually. I could release an animal with the Europe icon into the wild. It would be 3 conservation points. That's pretty good. That is actually not too bad. So I'm going to put... Where are we going to put stuff? Because I kind of want to get down here to draw that card. Releasing an animal with a Europe icon into the wild. Now you lose the icon, but I think that's okay. Yeah, okay. Ricky's in. Thank you very much, Ricky, for popping in. And for those people interested, Ricky's started a series of videos on this game. I think you've just done the first one, haven't you? But yeah, go and check out Ricky's Box of Delights YouTube channel, as he's doing solo playthroughs. Not live, like this one, so properly filmed and edited. I don't know where to put these 3. Right, that's going there. Kiosk is going there. Pavilion is going there, getting me 5 money and an appeal. And then this one is going here. I think. Okay, so that's building done. And what you're not seeing in this game is you're not seeing the large bird aviary or the reptile house. Next time I play, I might try and go for that. Though every time you play, it'll be different depending on what cards come out. Oh, part 3 is editing now. Excellent. And yeah, releasing the thing is you get a free enclosure again, which means you can put another animal in. Yes, very good point. Anyway, oh look, my association is on level 5, which means I'm going to do it. So we're going here, and I'm going to put a cube on this herbivores one, because I have 5 herbivores. So which one of these do we want? I'm going to take this one that allows me to snap a card. And I'm going to take that card. And it's 5 herbivores, which means I get 5 conservation points, which is 1, 2, bonus, 3, 4, choose end game scoring card, 5. So, lots of things have just happened. Let's look first at the bonus. Which bonus of these do I want? Do I want 10 money or a university? I've not really bothered with the universities much, so I'm just going to take 10 money, but I will get rid of the other bonus one, since nobody else can get it. I have to choose which final scoring card I want, so I'm going to get rid of the one for sponsors. And because I've done that, I can make a donation. Now, the donation comes from cubes off the board, so I spend 5 money, and I get another conservation point. Move a cube to donation board from solo board. Ah, did I forget to do that? Have we had 3 rounds? Use the solo cube to mark your action, then don't forget to shift the cube. Yeah. Okay, so it looks like... Have we had 3 rounds? Have I missed one? So that should be there, which means that should be there, which means I need to pay an extra 2. Is that right? There you go. Got all flustered then for a minute. I think that's right. I think we've fixed it. These need to slide down. And then that's done, and that goes over. Okay, so what Ricky's saying is actually take the cube from here and put it on the card. That's a step further from what I was doing. That's actually a good one. Yeah, I think that's a good one. So that's what I'll do. Top tip from Ricky. Take this and we mark the card that we're going to do with it, and then you put the cube back so that you know you've tracked it. So I've got another association card, but I can't do that action again because I need an extra worker. So I'm not sure what we're going to do with this one. I mean, I could go for that, which gets me another worker. I could just go for cards because I don't really have much in the way of cards in hand. Yeah, is there anything I want to snap? Expert on the Americas, all that's a bit late now. Yeah, no. Okay, so we're going to choose the cards action. I'm going to draw three and discard one. So I draw three cards. Well, we got two little size one animals and we got an expert on Australia. We have no Australia cards whatsoever, so we'll get rid of that one. And then this card goes over and that goes there. Yeah, that's a really good idea. I like that. The mess up wasn't from the turn cube, but from rushing through the break phase, forgetting some income and donation track. Okay, I'll do that next time. Yeah, I did rush through the break phase thinking, oh, I've got this sorted now. But I'll do it in order next time. But I don't think I forgot anything else. I did do my income. And I did do that. I did get that in the end. Yeah. So that's that done. And now it's my last turn for this round. And I could introduce an animal. Can't quite. Oh, no, I could. Because that needs two lizards. And this has got a lizard on it. So if I play this one first, I can then play that one. And suddenly I've got even more small animals. So we could totally do that. Is that what we want to do? Oof. I think it might be. Yeah, I think that's what we're going to do. We're going to choose the animals action. I'm going to play two animals. The first animal I'm going to play is a common Agama, which requires a size one enclosure. So we're going to flip that over. It costs me 9 money. I don't get a discount. And it's got sunbathing too. I can sell up to 2 cards from my hand for 4 each. I'm going to sell that one, because I don't want it, for 4 money. Okay, that's got 3 appeal. 1, 2, 3. And then my second one is I can play from within my reputation range. I can play this one, which requires me to have 2 lizard icons already, which I do. It requires a size 2 enclosure. It's going to cost me 14, but I get a discount of 3 because of the partner zoo in Asia. So it's going to cost me 11. And this is going in a size 2 enclosure here. And this has got constriction, but in a solo game, it's basically I can place any action card on one. That's got 7 appeal. Nice. Okay, have I done that right? The expert discounts small animals played. This one. Yeah, if I had that, but it's way too late for that. Thanks for popping in, Luke. And if you want to find out where this game sits on Luke Hector's top 10 games of the year, go and check out his video that went live yesterday. I'll give you a hint. It's in there, but I won't tell you where it is. No spoilers. Right. We're done. We're done. Break time. So let's do this correct. Hand size. I'm all right. I've got 1 card in hand. Remove those tokens. Doesn't matter. Repopulate the board and bring the workers back. Okay. Remove the two cards from here. Everything slides down. And now income. So I get 29 money. Right. Then I've got my kiosks, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 more money. Wow. Kiosks strong. Income from sponsor cards. I don't have any. And then income from here. I get one conservation point and I get to snap a card. Any card. Ooh, which card do we want? Well, what are we going to do? We are going to be releasing probably something from a size 1 or size 2 enclosure for this card. How many Asia icons have we got now? Oh, we got 3 Asia icons. I've got that. Could do that. Right. Is there any of those cards that I actually want? I don't know whether there is. I don't think there's any of those cards that I want. Because I can't... There's no point in me building a petting zoo at this stage in the game. That would get me appeal when I played it, and it doesn't take up space, and if I have 5 kiosks, I get a conservation point at the end of the game. I've only got 3. That's probably the only one that I'm thinking of that might be of any use. So, we'll take that. Because I can. Yeah, I don't know why it's called snapping. Does seem a bit weird. Right, we're done. We did the income properly, and then that cube goes on here. And we are now down to the final 2 rounds, I believe. So, my first action. I need the association to be further up. I'm building, and I'm literally just building one. I think I am. But it's not worth it. It is not worth... What I'm thinking of is if I build 5 kiosks, I can get 1 conservation point. But if I build more than 1 kiosk, I lose a conservation point. So there's no point doing it? Do we just take money? Or do we just play the sponsor card? We'll play the sponsor card. And we will put an expert on the Americas into play. And when it comes into play, I get 1 appeal for every Americas icon on my board, which is 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 appeal. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? Immediate effect. It also has an ongoing effect and an end of game effect. But that's the sponsors card done. That moves to there. Not many turns left. Not many turns left. Yeah, you can't build multiple kiosks in one turn. No, I was thinking of building one and then getting a free one, and then that would have been the 5. If the timing would have worked out. Right. I still can't do the association action. Because I've no bonus markers. So I'm going to have to do the build just to build one building at a cost of 2. Do we want the kiosk? Or do we want the pavilion? I mean, at this stage in the game, I think we want the pavilion. So I'll put the pavilion there, getting me 5 money and 1 appeal. In fact, do we even want the 5 money at this stage, or do we want the bonus token? How do I get this extra worker? I had a plan. It's not going to work. It's not going to work. I think we're okay. I think I'll take the money. Is there points for money at the end of the game? I can't remember. If there isn't points for money at the end of the game, which I don't think there is, it's been so long since I played. No, I'm not seeing any points for money at the end of the game. So actually, I don't need the money. I will take the bonus marker just in case. So I've built with my size, with my strength 5 building action, I have built one pavilion. That's that done. That goes there. That's a really good tip, that, Ricky. Thank you. Which means, as my last action for round 5, we do the association action. Take one of these workers, I put it here. Now, are we releasing into the wild for 3 conservation points? Or are we doing the Asia icons, of which I only have 3? No, it's going to be the Bavarian Forest National Park. So that slides along to there. That goes on there. And we are going to release this one. The Alpine Ibex. Now, do you lose the appeal? Ah, you lose the appeal, don't you? I think you lose the appeal. It would make absolute thematic sense if you lost the appeal. You lose the appeal depicted in the lower right corner, but you... Yeah, okay. Oh, rats. So instead, we're going to keep the Alpine Ibex. And we are going to release into the wild the Slow Worm, which is size 1, but it only loses me 2 appeal. So I'm going to flip over a size 1 enclosure. There you go. That is then free. And I take a cube. And it's going to be that cube, which gets me a worker. And it's going to go on here. So I get 1 reputation for playing the card. And I get 3 conservation points. And that Slow Worm has been released. Is that right? I think I've done that right. How many appeals should we cost Paul for the 2 coins he didn't spend? Or the appeal he forgot to add? What have I forgotten to add? Oh. What did I forget to pay for? Oh. I miscounted my number of spaces on my board. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Well, I wouldn't have built it then. Yeah. Okay, if we can undo that, I wouldn't have built it. So I lose the 1 appeal that I got for building it. I lose the 5 cash, but then I get the 2 cash back. And I literally just did the build card and did nothing. So I didn't count the bonus icon on the card itself. Animal from the display. Oh, did I forget to do that again? So, okay, so I'll pay an extra 2. Oh, the Indian rock python. I forgot to pay for the extra. See, I'm always forgetting that rule. And I didn't count an America's icon on the sponsor card I played. Didn't I? Oh, you mean it's got one itself? Ah, right, okay. There we go. Yeah, I forgot cards always count for themselves, don't they? So I think we're good. And I undid my building of my pavilion. Because I didn't want to go below 18. Anyway, where are we up to? I've done this, haven't I? So I've released an animal into the wild. And, oh, I can also pay to do a thing. So I will. I'll pay 10 money to put another cube on there, which gets me another one of these. There you go. So I'm gonna win. And then that goes there and we have a break. Okay, so hand size of 3, I'm all right. Cards shuffle down. This worker comes back. Got so many workers now. And income, get a conservation point. Can snap a card if I want to. We'll come back to that in a minute. And I get 30 money. 1, 2, 30. And my kiosks, I get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Another 10. There you go. I think I've undone everything. Errors fixed. All good. Smashing. Right. That cube goes on here. And we now start the last two turns of the game. Oh, I can snap a card. Is there any of these cards of any use whatsoever? Yes. That one, but I can't play it because I haven't got that. Ugh. That I can't play because of that. That requires a size 5 enclosure. That gets me nothing. Can't play that, can't play that. So I don't want to snap any of those cards. They're all completely useless to me. Right, two turns left. I have won because of this, but let's see what score I can get. I don't really know how, to be honest. Let's draw some cards. So it's draw 3 and choose, draw 3 and discard 1. I've got a Eurasian brown bear, a science library, or a Nile crocodile. None of these are any good for me in any way at all. Wow. Yeah. Now that one, that's going to get me something. So that's going to get discarded. That's that done. And now my last action of the game, because I don't want to build. Can we do any more over here? Can I do the Predators one? No, the Asia icons I can do. Yeah, this I can actually do, which will also get me that. So that's probably the best move. Oh no, that requires an association of 5. I can only get an association of 3. I can still do that, which is 1 conservation point. And I could get that, and I could get that. Yeah. Oh, yes. Can I do that? I can. Right. I think this is the best move, is I am going to choose the association action. I am going to boost it with a bonus token to make it 3. I then put my worker on here to get a partner zoo, because I can, because my association card has been approved. I will have a one in Europe. Because I put it on there, I get a worker, and my worker gives me 2 conservation points. And I can do a donation at a cost of 12. I've got so much money. That's a ridiculous amount of money. For another cube, but you don't need to put a cube on, for another 1 conservation. And there we go. That, I believe, is it. Now, I don't think you do a break at the end of the game. When only 2 tokens are left, you move the bottom one to the right. Do not trigger another break, but do final scoring instead. So, final scoring, I reveal my naturalist's zoo. I have 18 empty spaces on my board. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Which gets me 3. Can't see because of the big stack of cards. 1, 2, 3. That's it. I didn't manage to get 5 kiosks, so I don't have any other final scoring cards. Determine victory points. So basically, this marker goes there. And I've got 52, 71, 19 points. I think that's right. Is that right? 19 points. Play with the ice cream starting map and a sick amount of money. Right. Okay. I think we're done. Yeah, and yeah, as you've seen, starting on 20 appeal for a player of moderate experience. I think for your first game, start on 20, but I don't think I'm going to play the game again on 20. Because I did that and it felt okay. So I'm probably going to up the difficulty next time I play to 10. Yeah, basically, start with 10 or even 0. So if we'd started with 0 appeal, that would have been a lot harder because we would have had hardly any income. So I don't think I definitely wouldn't have done it starting on 0. Would I have done it starting on 10? Possibly, possibly not. But I've not played with any of the asymmetric boards yet. So just if you don't know the game, just so you know, the game comes with lots of boards which are all asymmetric. The map A's are the beginners ones, but this is map 5, this is the park restaurant, and they all have unique abilities, slightly different things on the left-hand side, and stuff like that. So yeah, 8 different ones, all with different things. And Luke's referring to the ice cream one, which is the ice cream one. Observation tower. Commercial harbour. It's probably the one I've got. Here we go, ice cream parlours. So all of your kiosks covered. All kiosks covered. Oh, so if you manage to cover both of those, then you gain income, extra income for each additional kiosk. And there's other abilities here and stuff like that. So yeah, all slightly different boards which you can use. But we're done. That is it. And if you look at the big stack of cards here, this is how many cards I went through in a solo game. So there's 212 cards in the game. That is the big stack of cards still. We only saw a quarter of the cards, if that. So yeah, huge amount of variability in the game. And that's where the similarity to Terraforming Mars ends, in my opinion, is the fact that there are a large number of unique cards. So every time you play, you will get different cards coming out, and you will have to do different things based on that. But other than that, I don't believe there's any comparison. I'm actually curious to know how many of you watching this video at the start didn't know much about the game and have heard about the comparisons to Terraforming Mars, who now, having seen the game, think the same as me, which is actually there aren't really any comparisons at all other than the cards. But yeah, we're now done. Thank you very much for everybody for watching me live, and thank you to everybody who's watching this afterwards. As mentioned at the start, this is not a sponsored video. These videos are only made possible thanks to the support of the Patreon campaign. So huge thank you to all of my Patreon supporters for helping fund the channel. And if you want to help support the channel directly, you can do so at patreon.com/gamingrules. We are only 19 supporters away, or 20 supporters away, from reaching 800 when I have special things planned. Hopefully that will happen sometime January or February of next year. But yeah, big thank you to everybody for supporting the channel this year. It's been another difficult year with everything that's going on. I will be back. What day is it now? Tuesday. Yeah. So I will be back on Thursday with some more live streams. Luke from the Broken Meeple is coming here for the day. We're going to be playing this two player in the evening. We've got Tabanusi in the afternoon, and we're going to be playing this. So if you want to see me and Luke playing this two player with him here in person, sat just there where the camera is, that will be happening on Thursday night at 8 o'clock. Set your reminders. The video is not on the channel yet, but I will be creating it later on today or probably tomorrow. But yeah, for now, thank you very much for watching. Take care, everybody. I'll see you soon.